Welcome to another edition of Penn Football Weekly, here with Quaker head coach Ray Priori. Coach, you're coming off of your team's first nationally televised collegiate primetime game at Franklin Field, 34-20 win over Yale. What was the experience like for you and your team?
Well, again, it was another Ivy League game, but let's not lose sight of the fact there was obviously a lot of excitement playing on Friday night. Kids getting that national exposure. It's great for the school, great for the league, great for the program.
So you dug out of a 10-point hole that you fell into in the first quarter. You've had a lot of practice with that this year. How crucial is that climbing out?
Well, obviously, that was what the thing that propelled us. But we've been in it before, which is helpful. Our kids had a great poise and composure. When it happened, we relaxed and went down and had a successful drive after that and really got the tables turned up. Ironically, in those first two scores by them, we could have dropped an interception, which would have stopped the one drive, and then we fumbled on the 13-yard line. So we're closer to having that not become a habit, hopefully, any further down the road. Yeah.
Four defensive turnovers forced, just one turnover on offense. How crucial was it to win the turnover battle for you?
Well, in any game, any sport, I don't care. The turnover battle is the key for success. We stress that every single day. We try to go. Our goal is to get four turnovers every day in practice. And if we do that, we really feel that's that'll put it to our offense in a great position to score. It equals the time of possession. And last week, that equaled to 20 points. On the flip side of it, securing the ball is everything. The game's all about the ball. Having the ball, keeping it is a key.
You swept the Ivy League Player of the Week honors this week, offensive player, defensive player, and rookie. What does that say about the talent and depth on your team?
Sure. I think right now our kids are performing. We happen to have three kids who won the awards, which is great. First time in a long time that's happened, so very proud of them. But it's a team sport. Each of them couldn't have attained those goals without obviously a lot of people around them doing things well. So great individual awards. We love that. But the team mindset and concept is still there.
Picked up back-to-back Ivy League wins. How do you see the team gelling as you move into kind of the meat of the Ivy League schedule?
Yeah, aside from the wins, is just we're getting better playing the game. I think by quarter, ever since the Fordham second half, we've been playing better football each quarter. We get better as the game goes on, so we'll tighten up that, but I think we're growing week by week. Our young kids are beginning to get more mature as we go through each game.
So next up is Brown on the road. It's been a tough place for Penn to play in recent history. What do you need to do to be successful against the Bears?
Well, I think Keith, as you mentioned earlier, is win the turnover battle. I think that is important. On offense, have consistency, keep doing what we've been doing, which is scoring points. And then they have a very, very talented group on both sides of the ball, but their senior quarterback is really talented. They have three wide receivers they can go to. So, minimizing the big plays on offense, they're going to move the ball. They're going to get yards. Key thing is minimizing it. And they do a great job of a little bit of trickery as soon as they cross the 50-yard line. So we got to do a good job of watching out for some of those trick plays.
So that is the upcoming task. Anything that fans should know about heading into the Ivy League stretch for your team? How important is the fan support coming home for Princeton's Ivy League homecoming game?
Well, I hope that everyone on Saturday tunes into the Ivy Digital Network and watches us there, to be quite honest with you. Because the only thing in our kids' minds are today's practice being Thursday, then getting on the bus tomorrow, Friday, and winning and having success, if you wish, at Brown. All those games will be there, and we'll get ready for them as they come across.
So next week's edition of Penn Football Weekly will be at Houston Hall, and you can see the Penn Quakers taking on the Brown Bears on the Ivy League Digital Network. Thanks, Coach.
Yeah, you're welcome.